Hello guys, it's time for another video, and today I will start a little series all about the TS Photon Newtonian series. In this video I will cover some theory about this telescope type, I will do a little unboxing, and I will show you what you can expect from such a telescope. And then there will some more videos follow. The next one is about the collimation. This is always an interesting and very important part in Newtonian telescope, using the collimation of the mirrors. And then, as soon as the weather permits, I will start doing some serious astrophotography with it. And I'm really looking forward to that. But first of all, what is this, the TS Photon series? Well, when you are looking for an affordable telescope which is able to do astrophotography and visual observing, then this is the proper choice. There are, for example, on the other side, there are Dobsonians. They are only for visual observing because of the mount and the mirror configuration. And on the way other side, there is the ONTC and the UNC series. These are highly tailored telescopes, specific for your needs. With the ONTC series, you can select the focuser, the secondary mirror, the length of the tube, something like that. So really tailored, also a bit more pricey. This one here is really affordable, I think. And this is because they are composed of stock components. We have GSO mirrors, TS Crayford focuser, stock components, but nicely manufactured. All these extra parts here are covered in red, painted red, so also looking really nice. You can easily distinguish the Photon series from other brands and series by this red color, so that's pretty nice. And yeah, let's start with some more in-depth views of the telescope. Of course, first I think we start with the tube. Okay, so now what do we have here? For this demonstration here, I choose the 8-inch F4 with a metal tube. They are also available with carbon tube. A carbon tube may be an issue. A carbon tube is a good choice if you want really the best quality of the tube. With this metal tube, you may have issues when the temperature drops over the night that you have to refocus because the length is changing. With a carbon tube, don't have these issues. So this is also an absolute correct choice. And yeah, the F4 is super compact. We have 800 millimeter focal length. Really compact. It is designed, or it is possible to mount it on an EQ5 class mount. That's also what my intention is. Let's start with the focuser, the most prominent thing here. This is a Crayford style focuser from TS. It's common design, there's nothing special about it. One thing to mention is you get this one here, a gear reduction, a 1/10 gear reduction, and that means you can move the focuser very precise. This is really important for astrophotography. For visual observing, it may be enough to adjust this way, but for photography, you will need this reduction here. Super nice. Mounted finder shoe, of course, and what you also get our tube rings and a GP Vixen style dovetail. Don't worry about this here, I just put a piece of tape on it to not to scratch it. And so when we have a look in the front, then you see it's all nicely black painted. Whoops. Screws getting a bit loose. Everything's painted matte black or some sort of dark gray. And here on this vein, on this spider, sits the secondary, and the secondary is larger than in the standard ones. This one has 70 millimeter diameter, and this is good for photography because it illuminates a larger field of view, a larger camera. You can illuminate a larger camera sensor with it. Yeah. And let's turn it around. On the back, on the primary cell, here you see the primary shining through. So the cell is open. And together with this fan here, it helps just cool down quicklier. With this fan here, you can apply a steady airflow that goes through the tube, and this helps cooling down the primary mirror. And for adjustment, you have these six screws here. I will cover them in detail in the collimation series, but just to mention, this is a cool idea. You don't need any tools to adjust your mirror. You can do it by hand. This is on really nice knurled knobs here, easily doable by hand. Cool. And now, what else in the box? So this is what we else have in the box. We have our finder scope, an 8x50 straight finder scope. We have an extension, a 2-inch extension that comes into the focuser. When you want to use the telescope visually, you have to use this extender because the focal plane is brought more out than for Dobsonians, for example, where only visual use is intended. For photography, you need a focal plane that is far out. And to reach this with an eyepiece, you need the extender. And this is the well-known 2-inch to 1.25-inch reduction. And this one is a battery holder for the fan in the back. So if you don't have a power supply, you can just use batteries for this purpose. Well, that's it so far for the telescope. Just a quick dry review that you see what you get with a TS Photon. The other telescopes are similar looking, but then with different dimensions, of course. So for now, that's it. Thank you so far. If you're interested in photography, you might be also interested in my setup that I'm planning to use. So stay tuned for that. Just a minute. Yeah, as I said, I will do some serious astrophotography with it. It's now a beginning of February, winter time. There are still already some interesting nebulas out there. And with 800 millimeters focal length, you have plenty of options what to shoot. So I'm planning to use this telescope with this camera here, a ZWO ASI 294 MC Pro. This is an OSC camera with a near APS-C sensor. 11 megapixels, it's a wonderful camera, absolutely easy to use. And this camera will give 1 pixel per arc second in resolution. And this is nearly a perfect match for normal Mediterranean skies, absolutely perfect match. But now the point is you have an optical effect in Newtonians, and this is called coma. We have a spherical primary mirror, and these mirrors always suffer from coma. That means the farther you get out from the center of your image, then the stars become more and more elongated. They get a little coma on it, like a comet. And to overcome this and to solve this, there are coma correctors available. Something like this optical element that comes in the focuser before your camera. And for this series, and especially the F4 type, the TS GPU is suggested. And this is the corrector I will use. So this corrector has 2 M48 threads, one in the front, one in the back. In the front, you can easily screw your light pollution filter in. In my case, an Optolong L Pro filter. And on the back, you have a stop ring, which is removable. So if you want a system or a setup where everything is screwed together, there are screw-in adapters available. In my case, I will just use it in the 2-inch clamping. But there's an issue. If you see it, never put your GPU or also other correctors in this way in the tube, because when it fall down, there's no stop ring anymore. When it fall down and hits your secondary, that would be really, really ridiculous. So when clamping it, always use the stop ring. The stop ring also enables you to adjust the distance to the camera, because sometimes you have to adjust these 55 millimeters. Oh, it's 55 millimeters distance for the GPU by amount of a couple of tens of millimeters. So, and this is my optical train, nothing more. That's super easy and very, very stable. There's no movement in it. So this is it. Super, super, super simple. I love such a setup. Normally I'm guiding with an OEG and with an off-axis guider mounted here. They are available from ZWO especially, which replaces one of the spacers. So this is absolutely fine and a good way to go. With this rather simple setup here, with this rather simple telescope, I also can use an external guider. This is just a guide scope, 8x50 guide scope with a ASI 120 mini camera in it. And this is used to correct the mount misalignments and mechanical issues of the mount. Auto guiding, so-called auto guiding. And this one replaces our finder scope. When using it in photography, we don't need the finder scope anymore, because I'm doing plate solving, so this is not an issue at all. If you want to use the finder scope parallel to the guider, then I would suggest to equip the telescope with a Y-shaped finder shoe. They are available also, just makes out of one finder shoe too. Then you can connect both your finder scopes to it. Okay, so now this is my intended setup. I'm pretty sure that this will work, and keep an eye out on the next videos. The best way is to subscribe to the channel and hit the notification bell, so you get a notification when next video is uploaded. Thank you very much for now. Bye bye.